Hello. This is a video type video follow-up to yesterday's video about wealth and whatever. And we'll see if later I can put up a more normal information video. Because it's taken me a while to get this together. I tried to make an off my head video of it, but got myself dreadfully confused, so I've had to write it out. So what I'll do, I'll probably do this video as a presentation and have my writing out in down there, so we can read along and try and make sense of it. Now, obviously, what I'm not trying to do is to say this is how it is. These are obviously discussion points that we can use. So, firing off yesterday, wealth, everything is wealth, absolutely everything. The used mask that I used to sweep the chimney yesterday is wealth. As in, it could be valued by somebody, and absolutely everything in the world can be valued by somebody, but we'll come to that later. Okay, so everything is wealth, not because it has value, but because it exists to be valued. That just is a second expression of what I just said. This exists to be valued. Now, there might be one or two things that can't be valued, or nobody actually wants in the world an old bit of plastic. But let's note that a particular artist at a particular time might want a particular bit of plastic to put in a particular artwork to work in a particular way. In other words, we might as well just say everything, every bit of stuff is wealth. Now, for the whole of this, you can actually put in stuff where I put in wealth, and I don't think it's going to alter things, but I'm going to stick with wealth. But if you don't like me expropriating the word wealth, I'm not trying to steal the word, so put the word shazbat in. It doesn't really matter, but I'm just trying to establish some things that we can think of, some concepts as opposed to vocabulary definitions, right? So everything is wealth. Everything is stuff, so everything is wealth. It's potentially valuable because it exists to be valued. Everything that exists can be valued, therefore, everything is wealth. Yeah. I could put potential in here, but I don't want to confuse things. When we get more advanced, I'm sure we can use the word potential, and that'll be very interesting stuff. But for the moment, I appreciate the word potential, but I'm putting it aside. People exist, so of course our wealth. People are stuff. See, this is where it would get tricky, putting stuff in instead of wealth. People are also there to be valued. They are stuff. They are wealth. Just a reiteration of that. I don't want to steal the word wealth. We can use any word. I'm not worried. It's just the concept I'm trying to talk about, not the word. Okay. So valuating. I note that all animals can valuate things. Even plants can be said to valuate things. But as in, plants could value water when they're being watered. Dogs can valuate their master as opposed to the postman. Yeah, but let's stick to humans, all 7 billion of them. And note that all stuff has 7 billion different values. All stuff, all wealth has various values. We're only going human here, so it's got 7 billion of them. 7 billion different values. People. Okay, people we know from above, people are wealth. That's hopefully understood from above. People are wealth in this understanding of it. From above, all people valuate things. So we are wealth in ourselves. And because we're humans in this one, we go around valuating things. That is just one of the things that we do. So from above, all people valuate other people. So we don't just valuate that or my cup of tea. We valuate each other. So getting on to the practical, cars. From the above, cars are obviously wealth because they're stuff, they exist, they can be valued. Cars are wealth. And it's the people that valuate the cars that we know now. So, wealth creation, and when we get this is where we get to the tricky bit. And that's just an open question. Wealth creation. We'll come on to the end and say that I'm going to kick out wealth creation, but don't get upset about it because it's concepts I'm trying to get to, not words or phrases and what they mean. Wealth making. To build a car is to transform wealth. It's the transformation of stuff. It's the transformation of wealth. The metal and rubber, which is stuff, which is wealth, is now more valuable. So the metal and rubber has been transformed into different stuff, different wealth, which has an aggregate different valuation. Valuable being based on the 7 billion human valuations. So a note, not all 7 billion valuations are equal, as in, well, that's obvious. I've just put in here because I'm going to use it later. Let's just say that the closer you are to the wealth to be valued, let's say to the car, if it's in your driveway, the more your valuation counts. As in, your valuation of your car in your driveway is different from mine valuation of your car because it's over there in your driveway. So I would have a different valuation. The closer it is to you, the more your valuation is important. So on that counts, your valuation counts. We open up to the world of economy and economics via the words average and aggregate. We don't need to get caught up with this. We could say that the economy is X many valuations of Y amount of wealth, but we won't go into that. That's not necessary today. So, does a hairdresser create wealth? Now, this is what hopefully the title of this video will be. Does a hairdresser create wealth? And first of all, I'm just going to say repeat no, because no one creates wealth in this description. I am kicking out the old expression wealth creation and creating wealth. Why? Because I think it's got so many things tied onto it that we can't even think about it clearly. So I'm asking you to throw that out, that all those ideas you have about wealth creation and all that, throwing it out, and we're going with this. Not, and again, I'm not trying to re-establish vocabulary of words or expressions. I'm just trying to get to concepts here. So just throw it out, go with me. So in the all we've got is wealth being transformed. Not forget all that creation stuff. Just transformation. Wealth is being transformed. Stuff is being transformed. Valuations of the transformed wealth therefore might change. It's being transformed, but we haven't necessarily got it. Just because you transform something, the valuation will go up. You can transform it with a hammer, and the valuation might go down. It's being transformed, and the valuation from the 7 billion aggregate changes. But obviously, of those 7 billion, there are some that are more important than others. Dig? Yeah. So all we're doing is all we've got in this concept that I'm trying to go for is wealth, which is stuff, is being transformed and then revaluated. That transformation is being revaluated. Okay. For example, we get a place with 99% are hairdressers and 1% are car makers. Would make for car makers with high valuations and hairdressers with low valuations. I think hopefully everything's fine there. And cars naturally would have high valuations because they'd be rarer because there are fewer makers of them. And haircuts would have lower valuations. But market forces tend to level out the percentages in real life. In other words, that's a silly hypothetical. In real life, market forces tend to level out the percentages, and we have the right amount. Never will be the right amount, but you can see what I'm trying to say. It will never be 99 to 1. It'll be something that's closer to what's right. We'll have the right amount of car makers and hairdressers. And so we get to the question, what are hairdressers doing? What is a hairdresser doing in what I'm trying to establish here? all we've got, same as the car maker, is transformation of wealth, transformation of stuff. So hairdressers transform wealth. They're transforming wealth. Not much wealth to transform there, but that can be transformed. Stuff can be transformed. Remember, everything is wealth. The whole thing, the little, the thing, aspects of thing, everything can be valuated. So all those valuations are wealth. And that, again, I'll repeat it here, change the word if you like. The wealth word. You can change it to stuff, change it to zazbat. I don't care what the word is. Therefore, so the hairdresser transforms the wealth, transforming the valuation of this wealth, transforming the value to the person closest to the wealth. I am closest to the wealth, which has been transformed. The valuation that I put upon this new transformed wealth is different to the valuation that I put on it before. So in normal language, the haircut makes the person with the haircut value themselves, particularly this, but I can do a whole overall because, forget my old YouTube videos, I evaluate this whole thing as me, and I evaluate me with this transformed is more valuable to me than it was before the haircut. And probably I evaluate that other people evaluate that this me, the value of this me is raised in the community around me as well. In other words, a hairdresser in this way is no different from the car maker. Might have to go again, but I'll leave it with you to discuss.